Hello and welcome to this fifth video of LabVIEW for C programmers. In this video I will start showing you some of the good stuff about LabVIEW. You've seen me doing a lot of things in the past videos, and probably you are wondering, okay, why, if I have to click so much to make so little code, why would I want to use LabVIEW? Well, in this video I will start showing you some of the good stuffs, and one of the things is function calls. You all know function calls, of course, and if you are doing function call in C, what you get is just a very simple function call, and that's it. If you do a function call in LabVIEW, they are easier to make, and what you can do as well is, if you are making a function call, you immediately get a user interface and you also get some kind of code for unit testing. So if you stick around, I will show you a little bit more about it. So let's start with the basic example we're going to do today. We will do something with a circle. If we have a circle, we can take the diameter and we can calculate the radius, because the radius is half the diameter. And we can calculate the area, and we can calculate the circumference with the basic formulas. Areas is pi squared r, pi r squared times r squared, and circumference is pi times d. So with this simple formulas, we will start doing some examples of making a function call. So let's first move this one away. I will get to the code. Here I've made some fun with circles code in C. We'll start with some floating point numbers, which are going to be our variables. So first we have to define pi, and then we are going to make an r for the radius. The area is it's not really needed here. I'm sorry, I will also make sure I select the lines, because I've found out that they are not showing up in the videos. Here we have some other information which is being calculated. Then of course this line is the one we are interested in. It's where we are going to get the diameter. If we have the diameter, we can calculate the radius, and from these two we can start calculating circumference and the area. And then we can export it. In this case, this is the main application, so we'll print it to the console, but in fact we can do anything with it. Well, first let's quickly program this as well in LabVIEW. So again, this is all familiar, shouldn't be a big new thing. First thing we'll do, we'll put in a diameter control, and here we have some internal variables. In the previous examples I made an indicator on all of them, but of course that's not really needed. So what we can do now, we can just start calculating the circumference if we want to. So again, I will put in an indicator in this case. I will call this one circumference, and I will also make one which I will call area. First we of course have to calculate the radius, so I will divide the diameter by 2. In this case I have now, this will be the radius at the output, and now we can go to select a constant, and here we get some of the background of LabVIEW, which is in the scientific industry. And I have a predefined constant of pi, so I don't even have to look up pi. This is way beyond all the numbers that the digits that you might need, and I can just start programming. So I can square the radius, and I can multiply it with pi, so I get the area. And I can also multiply it with the diameter, so I get the circumference. And now I can, as you know, run the program, and here you can see the output immediately, just like you're used to. So this would be, if you would have C, you would have a console program, and in the console program you can enter a diameter and then it will tell you the information. So far, so good. So this is the basic example. This is more or less for the people that are new to this video series. So just a quick introduction. Now, of course, what you can get in real life is that at a certain moment you want to have this kind of functionality. You are going to change it a little bit, or maybe you're going to call it from multiple places. And then you are going to change into something which might look like this, where you are going to generate two function calls, one for calculating the circumference and the other one to calculate the area. Then you will get a main program which looks like this. You are going to again ask for diameter, and then you are going to to select lines. So first you are going to query for the diameter, and then you are going to make a call where you get the diameter or the area, and you'll get the circumference. And you do that by calling either one of these functions. So let's first go to this situation. In this case, what you are doing is you are using a by value call function, and you are using the by value return value. In this case, of course, this is typical C. You get a return value which is entered here, and you can only return one return value. We'll get to the other situation just a little bit later. I will pause the video quickly so I can make a copy of untitled one to get to the same starting point in a few minutes. Okay, I made a copy. You can see the untitled has changed to untitled 1A. And now what I will do is I will make two separate function calls. Imagine you have this function in C, then you will have to manually reconstruct everything into adding a function here, and you will have to do some typing, and you have to make a function call, and you have to include the function call into this piece of text, and you will have to do a lot of work. If I would now want to do the same in LabVIEW, you may see it's much easier. The only thing I have to do is select some piece of code, and from the menu I say create sub-VI. Now I have made another LabVIEW program which contains the original code. I have a bigger screen so it jumps a little bit, but here you can see it even already automatically tried to fill in the values. I can do the same for this piece of code. I can say okay, edit, create sub-VI, and again I get a second VI which is the same as a function in C, and I can also show the code, and you can see it immediately takes the code, it generates a new piece of code, and it also inserts the function call into this in the original diagram. So I don't need to do anything special. I can just select some code in my original program. For example, yeah, here of course you cannot do it because it's in text, and some part of the text is here, some part of the text is there. So it's even difficult to do it within the C code. But yeah, you could imagine I could select this piece of text, that piece of text, and I will just press a magic button and it will make a function call. And I do the same here, and the same with area, and the same with this area here. And again, I will press a magic button and it will change the code into this. In C, this is something which you cannot do. In LabVIEW, it's just as easy as clicking a menu. I can show you that I'm not lying. For example, I can make a new VI. It will again pop out. Yeah, now I'm a little bit, I'm not really lying that much. The thing is, you need to save every VI, every file, and I didn't save them, so I cannot open them from the desktop or from the file manager, but at least I can still copy and paste them. So I can copy this untitled2.vi, which is the diameter which calculates the circumference. I will call this one circum. I can also change the picture if I want to, so I can make a nice drawing of the radius. And now I have a really nice symbol of my new program. You can see it automatically updates the icon here. I can do the same, I can even copy by pressing Ctrl C this icon, and I can do the same for the for the area calculation, and I will make it nice green inside, and you will see the icon changing to my new drawing. I'm still using LabVIEW 8.6 in this example. In the newer LabVIEW versions, the icon editor has changed and has improved a lot. But just believe me, it's this is roughly the same as you get in LabVIEW, the newer LabVIEW versions. Now, well, I have made my new program. I'm sure it's a little bit, that's one of the drawbacks of working with LabVIEW, is getting a little bit confusing that you can have so much code open. But what I can do is I can just select the area calculation function and I can paste it here just by pressing Ctrl C, Ctrl V. Now here I get the diameter and here I get the area. You can see it's saying numeric here and it's saying diameter there. Well, if I want to change it, I can just say, okay, this is my area indicator, and I will change it to area. And now if I will press create control here, I have a diameter. And now if I select create indicator here, it will automatically say area. Now I can open my new front panel and I get the diameter here, area there. And I can run it, continuous run it, and you will see that it calculates the area automatically. Okay, let's back up a little bit to recapture what I just did. So what I did is I started with a simple program which calculates the circumference and the area for a given diameter, and I recreated that program in LabVIEW. I can open the copy, which is entitled 1B. I can show you the block diagram. So this is what I made, which is exactly the same as you have here. Then I wanted to go to making something with two function calls, and I just selected this area here and pressed create sub-VI, and I did the same here and I made a new sub-VI as well. After doing that, I got, after making some nice modifications to the icons, I got this schematic of this diagram, this piece of code. And this code contains the calculation for the circumference, like you see here. And this piece of code contains the code for calculating the area. So again, if I move them all in, this is the original code. This is my new sub-VI 1. And this is my other sub-VI number 2. And the neat thing about it is that the only thing that I needed to do was click some magic buttons and it all happens automatically. And I could even show you that it's really true, because I could just take one of those functions and put them in some other piece of code. Okay, so this was for making an example where you have just one output. I will minimize it a little bit more. Yeah, okay, I will remove entitled 1A and I will stick to 1B, which is the original case. So what I showed you now is to make functions, which are the standard C functions, which have a return value and just one output. Of course, what you can do in C as well is to make a function call which starts using pointers. One of the drawbacks of using pointers is that some simple piece of code immediately becomes complex because at one moment you are talking about pointers, then you are talking about a pointer to a memory area, and then you are talking about that you are going to have to put in the reference or the address of that the original storage, and from that moment on it becomes less readable, the code. If you are a C programmer, you get used to it, so you just read through it with no problem. But if it's something you're not really used to, you get some you get confused. And another thing which can happen is that there is some mix-up. At a certain moment you think you need a pointer, and then you are not needing a pointer, but you are putting in something by value, and that's becoming can become very messy. As I told you before, in LabVIEW you don't have a similar thing. Everything is done by value. Of course, that has drawback as well. It takes more memory, and it also requires that you may need to make a copy of your data before you are making the function call. And that especially becomes a drawback when you are using a lot of data. We'll get to that later, where that is becoming a problem. Again, I will pause the video to make a backup copy of the original schematic, and then we'll continue. So now I've changed 1B to 1C, and now we'll do the same trick all over again. And I will give you a little bit more information now about why we just got numeric instead of circumference and area, and why we get diameter when we make a new function. This time we will make a function call which has one input and two outputs, and we can just do it like we are used to. We select some piece of code, we say okay, create subvi, which is the same as in C, make a function. We'll just let go of the mouse button and we'll see a new function being generated, and in this case there's one wire going in and there are two wires going out. Again, I can open it. I will have to drag it into this part of the screen, and I will now change the VI to call this one circle matrix. I can also change the name. Instead of using untitled 5, I can say okay, let's save this, and it will ask me for a name, and I will call it circle matrix. And now it's called circle matrix.vi instead of untitled 5. And you can see here that also the icon has changed again. What I can do is I can switch on the label so you can see what it is. And there is another neat feature in LabVIEW, which I just opened, which is the context help. You can see it here as well. I'm used to it, so I press Ctrl H. And now what I can do is I can float over some piece of code, and the context help will show me what's inside. So in this case, I can go to circle matrix, and it will tell me, okay, this is circle matrix. And another cool thing I can do is I can add some additional information. So if you are going through the code, for example, I can select some kind of remark. I can say, okay, VI properties. I can say documentation, and I will add some documentation. Calculate the area. Of course, this is not good because this needs to be a circumference of a circle. And now if I go over this function call, I will not just see the icon and the outputs, but I will also see the command I've added. So instead of just adding some green part in your code, you can really add a lot of stuff. You can even add help tags to it, so you can make a compiled help file with a lot of extra information. Okay, you see here there's numeric and numeric 2, and I already explained to you that I won't promised you that I will explain this, and I will do that right now. Why is this called diameter and why is this called numeric? When you create a LabVIEW always tries to make the correct name immediately for you. So if I look here, you can see this is the multiply function, and here the multiply function doesn't I would expect that that would be numeric, but it doesn't really have a name, and that's the reason why it just says okay, this is numeric. Typically if you have something which already has a name, it will try to use the name as much as possible. I will now name this output here, and I will also name this output here. And now when we go to this diagram again, you will also see that the context help even changed immediately, so that it's now circumference and area, and we have the help function as well. Well, this is one of course of the great features of LabVIEW. If you compare this function call, I can put in a drawing, I can do in anything. I can see my inputs which I have drawn at the left and the outputs which are drawn at the right. In fact, I could swap it, but then of course it's not that easy. But I can immediately see, okay, this is where my information is coming from, just like programming in C. You start top and you move down. In LabVIEW it's nice, it's not required, but it's nice to go from left to right in programming. So here you can immediately see, okay, I have a diameter, and with the diameter I'm going to do circumference and I'm going to calculate the area. If I would look at the same piece of code, which is roughly this piece of code, I get a little bit confused. I don't program that much in C, but if I look at this piece of code here, I cannot immediately see what is an input, I cannot immediately see what is an output, and I have to look into this part of the code to see what it's doing. Typically if you have a big file, this will be far far away, and then you have to select the control matrix and you do have to do a search or something to find the piece of code which is the part, and only then you can really see what's inside. So that's one of the things I like about LabVIEW. You make a function call, and it's in the end it just looks like a simple block. Suppose this wouldn't be open. I can close it because it's I made a file of it, I saved it, so I can close it. But suppose it's not open, I can just double click on it and it will open the VI and everything. Okay, so far for the making the function calls. Of course, one thing you will start asking is, okay, now you have a function call with one input and two outputs. Can I have multiple inputs and multiple outputs? And the answer, of course, is yes, you can. There is something which is called a connector pane. This is also different in LabVIEW 8.6 and in the new versions. In the new versions, the connector pane is always visible here at the left of the icon. But I can show you now, this is a connector pane. And the connector pane is something where you select the wire attachment to the icon. So if I would make a copy, just control drag. If I now would make a copy, I can again create a control here, or a constant, or an indicator, or whatever. So let's make a constant, let's say 4, and then I can create an indicator here to see the circumference. And this is the what's called the connector pane. I can show you, maybe if I select edit icon, I can say, okay, show me the terminals, and here you can see a grid where you have the connection panes. And in this case, I can select which connector pane is connected to which area. Now, you can imagine that we will have some very special thing. And instead of having the diameter, I also want to know the radius. So I get a new piece of code. I want to add a radius as well. So in this case, I will add a radius as an output. Now you can see it doesn't fit because all my connections are used. What I can select is I can, I can select the pattern, and I can select all kinds of patterns. And each pattern has some inputs and some outputs. And to make a very long story short, I will tell you that the only pattern you should use is this one. All the other ones you should not use. If you are using any one of these, you will run into a situation where you get too little connections and you are going to change the pattern. If you are going to use one of these, you will find it difficult to put your mouse on the right position, and what you get is that your top level or the calling VI will become really messy because of all the wires. So only use this one. If you use this, you get into problems because you have too little connections. If you are using these, you will get into problems because your calling diagram will be too difficult. So I will select this one. And then of course you will say, okay, what happens if I need more connections? Well, in this case you have already, it's the 4, 2, 2, 4. So it's 4 by 4, it's 12 inputs and outputs. If you are going to make a C function, which has 12 inputs and outputs, you will get a mess. If you really need more, you also in C would do something else. The most common thing to do is use structures, which are called clusters in LabVIEW. Okay. Now, what you will see is I've changed this pattern, and it will fill in some empty gaps and some empty, it will try to reconnect, and it will also have some empty spaces. What you can also see is that my top level program has become a broken arrow, which means a syntax error, and also these VIs have become grayed out. I can try to save it to maybe solve it, but still it gets a problem. One of the things which is really nice about LabVIEW is if you have a compile error, you can just press the run button and it will show you a list of all compile errors. And it will even tell you what to do. So in this case, it will say, okay, circle matrix, bad linkage to sub-VI. Another thing I can do is I can double click it and it will show me where the code is and already selected, so I can take action. This error is caused every time you change the connection pane. So that's also one of the reasons why I say, okay, only use this one. If you are using any other and you are going to add a terminal or you're going to select a different pattern, you will get this error. If you have unconnected terminals, that's not a problem. So what I will do now is I already did select this one and I will save it just to be sure that's a habit. And here I can say, okay, relink to sub-VI, and now it will reattach the wires. And it's the calling VI is fixed. Now, what I just told was that it's best to have all the inputs on the left and the outputs on the right. And here you can see, okay, this is top and bottom, so this is not really nice. So what I will do, I will disconnect some of the terminals. And you will see, again, compile errors, you will see broken lines. and that's because those are no longer connected. What I will do now, is I will again connect those items. Still, I have broken arrows, but here I can see I can lock the help so it doesn't change. You can see here again, okay, this is my input, these are my outputs, and I have now added radius. So now I have to fix these errors, and the easiest way is by first deleting all the wires. In this case, it's safe to press Ctrl B to remove all the wires at once, so I don't have to do it manually. And now I will just rewire circumference my stuff, and okay, it's safe now. So now I fixed the errors. And here you see one of the tricks which you have to be careful is that you always connect the right wire to the correct terminal. That's one of the typical problems or typical bugs you can insert into LabVIEW. Just like you have in C, you can make really nice bugs by doing something wrong with a pointer. You can do the same in LabVIEW by connecting the wrong terminal. As long as you are working in a nice and good way, and you are not going to put wires underneath, for example, I can do this. I can create an insert, an indicator. This is one thing you can do. You can put a wire underneath a VI, but that is something you should never do, and that's also one of the reasons why you see me shifting a lot with some parts at some moments like this, and that is has to do with the fact that I want to know for sure that the connections are correct. What you can see is if I move it, it will automatically align. So for example, if I would do something like this, if I now move this VI, it will automatically select it to the correct position. Okay, so this is about how to make connections. Now, what I have promised you is to show you that any function call, that was the promise that I made at the beginning, is both a function call or three functions. It's the user interface, and it's also a unit test function. So for example, I have now made my circle matrix VI, and what you would do if you have just C, you have your still you have your original program. Of course, this is a little bit stupid because it only has very little functionality, but in this case I already made something special. I made a second circumference. So I can select this one, which is my circumference for my fourth item. And well, let me also create an indicator, which is a radius 4. And of course, this is going to be wrong. I have on purpose inserted a bug. So now I have my radius of diameter 4, and I also want to calculate the radius of 4. If I now run this VI, so let's put this here, and I have my diameter, and my diameter, you can see me shifting around already with all the stuff to make the user interface a little bit easier for debugging, because of course this is not really a user interface you are going to use as such. But this is just a habit you will develop. And now I can continuously run this program, and you will see that if I change some stuff, I will get an area and a circumference, and I get the circumference. If I enter 4, I will get the same circumference as I had for my matrix, which is calculating for 4. And what I see is that my radius of a circle of diameter 4 should be 2. So now I run into a problem. If you would have been programming in C, Of course, you can put in a breakpoint and start debugging it. But the nice thing about LabVIEW, what I can do is I can again also put in a breakpoint. I'll have to do some other stuff, because normally you put in breakpoints for code which is running, but I will show you a different way. I can put in a breakpoint at this function. Now when I run the code, it will show you that it stops at the place where I put the breakpoint. So I put the breakpoint, in this case, at the function call. I can now step into the SubVI circle matrix, and it will automatically open the SubVI for me. I will now stop this debugging session. And what you will see is that it opened the front panel. And the front panel, in this case, is filled already with the values that I was using during my debug session. If I now run this function, I can just run it. It is already filled with the values which were causing the bug in the past, and I can just run it. And here I can see that my circumference is 12.566. My area is 12.664, which is correct because the square root of 2 is the same as the half of 2. And I can see that my radius is 0. And there are some really neat things in LabVIEW which you do not get in C. The first thing is that I had to make a panel where I have put in all my function inputs and my function outputs, so I can at any time see what's happening. The other thing what I can do is I can put in a breakpoint, so I can at the moment it goes wrong, I can also put in some conditional breakpoints, so I can say, okay, if something is going wrong, then stop. And what I get is that immediately I can open the function which is failing, which is already filled with all the parameters that I am using and which are causing the fail. So that's one of the benefits of using by value. If you would do something by pointer, you will not be able to do this. And I can now just start running this VI with the data which is causing the bug. Now the bug is very easy to solve, because what I didn't do is I didn't connect the radius to my calculation. Now I will connect the radius to the calculation, and I can run again, and I get the value 2. So now I know, okay, this VI is working. I can save it. And another cool feature what I can do, because my function call is the user interface and immediately is a program on itself, I can just play to see if everything goes right, and I can say, okay, this is good. Now I can close this VI. I can disable the breakpoint. I can run my top VI, and now I can see indeed my radius for 4 is calculated correctly. Okay, this was a lot of information. I hope it's not too much, but the good thing about videos, and especially on YouTube, is that you can just pause it, play it back, and try it again. So hopefully you will be back very soon, and the next thing I will try to show you are probably arrays, which is really something special again in LabVIEW. Thanks for watching, and hope you learned something. Bye.